In this video, we're going to complete the first page of the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Solving Systems of Inequalities. Our directions are to sketch the solution of each system of inequalities. Now, if you remember from graphing inequalities, we're going to graph each line like a y equals mx plus b using the slope m and the y-intercept b. So in number 1, the slope m is negative 1. So we'll write that as negative 1 over 1, rise over run. And the y-intercept, if we're in the form of y equals mx plus b, the y-intercept, when we're subtracting 2, is the same as adding a negative 2. So our y-intercept is negative 2. So I'll plot 0, negative 2, the y-intercept of that first inequality, and then using my rise over run, going down 1, so negative 1 in the y direction, and 1 over to the right in the positive x direction, albeit point 1, negative 3. Now I'll draw a line and connect those points. However, the type of line I draw depends on whether this is greater than or less than versus greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. Because it could potentially be equal, so because it is less than or equal to, that's going to be a solid line. Now I just need to figure out what side of that inequality to shade to. And the best way to do that is to pick a test point. Let's use the point 0, 0. So I'm going to plug 0 in for x and 0 in for y and see if that inequality, the first inequality, holds true. So if 0 is y, 0 is less than or equal to negative 0, or simply 0, minus 2. That says that 0 is less than or equal to negative 2. That is not true. Therefore, we're going to shade opposite the test point 0, 0. So we'll be shading to the left of this line. Now, looking at our next line, our slope m is negative 5. So I'll write that as either negative 5 over positive 1 or positive 5 over negative 1. Either is correct, since a negative divided by a positive is a negative. And our y-intercept b is equal to a positive 2. So I'm going to plot 0, 2, and then I'll go down 5 and over 1, so going down in the negative y direction and to the right in the positive x direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then over 1. So my next point is 1, negative 3. And because this is greater than or equal to, that will be a solid line. So I'll connect those two points with a solid line. Now I'll still use that test point of 0, 0 and see if I'm to shade that in or not. So for y is greater than or equal to negative 5x plus 2, 0 is greater than or equal to negative 5 times 0 plus 2, negative 5 times 0 is 0, so it says 0 is greater than or equal to a positive 2, which is not true. So I'm not going to shade in to the side that has that 0, 0 point, I'm going to shade in to the opposite side. Now, where my shaded marks intersect, that is the answer for this inequality. And you can see that that intersection occurs here. So that's my answer in number 1. Let's go on to number 2. In number 2, our slope for our first inequality is negative 1. So I'll write that as negative 1 over 1. And the y-intercept b is a negative 2. So I'll plot 0, negative 2, and then go down 1 in the negative y direction and 1 to the right in the positive x direction. An important thing to note is that this is greater than, not greater than or equal to, greater than. So I'm going to connect those with a dotted line. Now I need to figure out what side to shade. Let's again use that test point of 0, 0. So if I plug 0 in for y, I'll have that 0 is greater than, and plugging 0 in for x, 0 is greater than 0 minus 2, so I'll have that 0 is greater than negative 2, which indeed is true. So I'm going to shade into the side that contains that point 0, 0. Now, for my next line, I'll have y is less than negative 5x plus 2. So my slope m is negative 5, which I'll write as negative 5 over 1 or 5 over negative 1. and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So plotting 0, 2, and then going down 5 and over 1 in the positive x direction, I'll be at that point 1, negative 3. And this is less than, so it's going to be a dashed line. Now, using that same test point of 0, 0, I'm going to plug 0 in for y and 0 in for x and see if that inequality is true. Plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, I'll get 0 is less than negative 5 times 0 plus 2, so I'll have that 0 is less than 2, which is true. So I'm going to shade into the side that contains that point 0, 0, which for that new line was to the left. And you can see that intersection occurs in between those two lines. So deleting my previous shaded region, that is my answer in number 2, the intersection of those inequalities. Moving on to number 3, my slope m for my first equation is 1/2, and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So I'll plot 0, 2, for my y-intercept, and then using my slope, I'll find my next point. So going up 1 in the positive y direction and over 2 in the positive x direction to point 2, 3. And because this is less than or equal to, I'll be able to connect those with a solid line. Now I have to figure out what side of that line to shade to. So I'll use my test point of 0, 0. Plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, I'll have 0 is less than or equal to 1/2 times 0 plus 2. So that will be 0 is less than or equal to a positive 2, which indeed is true. Therefore, I'll shade to the side that contains that point 0, 0. Now, for my next inequality, my slope m is negative 2, so I'll write that as negative 2 over 1, and my y-intercept b is a negative 3, since that 3 is subtracted. So plotting my y-intercept, 0, negative 3, and then using my slope, I'll find my next point, so 2 down and 1 to the right in the positive x direction will be my next point. Now this line is less than, not less than or equal to, so I will draw it dashed or dotted. Now we have to figure out what side of that line to shade to. So plugging in 0 for y and 0 for x using that test point, I'll have 0 is less than negative 2 times 0 minus 3. So that's 0 is less than a negative 3, which is not true. Therefore, I'm shading opposite the side that contains the 0, 0 point, which is to the left of that dashed line. And you can see that my intersection of shaded regions occurs here. So that is my answer in number 3. Now I want to note that you do not necessarily have to choose the test point 0, 0. You could choose a test point of 2, 1 or 5, negative 2. Just using the test point of 0, 0 is easy because I know that any number times 0 is 0. So doing the math is a little bit easier. However, if this test point was to fall on one of the lines, then we would have to pick a point to one side of the line or the other side of the line. That is the case when we cannot use 0, 0. Continuing on to number 4, I have that x is less than or equal to negative 3. So that means regardless of the y value, x is always negative 3. So finding x is negative 3 on the number line, y can be 0, x is negative 3, y can be 3, x is negative 3, y could be negative 5, x is negative 3. So you can see that we'll have a vertical line, and because it's less than or equal to, it will be a solid vertical line. Now we can use our test point of 0, 0 in order to figure out which side of that line to shade to. However, it says that x is less than or equal to negative 3, and I know that 0 is not less than or equal to negative 3. So we're going to be shading to that opposite side where it does not contain 0, 0. So to the left of this solid line. Now moving on to our next line, it's in the form of y equals mx plus b, but as an inequality. So slope m is 5 over 3, and y-intercept b is a positive 2. So plotting point 0, 2, and then using our slope, we'll find the next point. However, going 5 up in the positive y direction will place us off of our graph. So I will just make this a negative 5 and a negative 3, since negative 5 divided by negative 3 is still a positive 5 thirds. So now we're going to move down 5 in the negative y direction and over 3 in the negative x direction to the point negative 3, negative 3. So note that this is less than, not less than or equal to, so I will connect those with a dashed line. And then I'll still be able to use my test point of 0, 0. So I'll plug 0 in for y and 0 in for x. So you can see again why it's easy to use 0, because 5 thirds times 0 is just 0. And I'll have that 0 is less than 2, which is indeed true. So I'm going to shade to the side that contains that point 0, 0, which is to the right or slightly below that line. Now I'm really just concerned about where those two intersect, which we can see is in this bottom section. So that is my solution in number 4. Anything within this shaded region and including this solid line will be true for each of these inequalities. So feel free to take this test point, negative 4, negative 5, and plug it in for each. Negative 4 is indeed less than or equal to negative 3, and plugging in negative 4, negative 5, negative 5 in for y, and negative 4 in for x will also be true when you work out that math. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 5 through 8. However, before you click that button to go on to that next video, remember to also click the like button, and while you're at it, subscribe to my channel.